Podcast.
All right, everybody, buckle up. We are about to take a deep dive into a topic I know you all are going to love.
Yeah, and what's that?
The Grammys.
The Grammys, yes. Love it.
We're talking about those golden gramophones, but more than just the award show itself, like, we really want to get into how they became such a big deal.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the music industry's biggest night.
Totally.
And it turns out there's actually a really kind of a surprising origin story here.
Yeah, you might even say a little scandalous.
Oh, juicy. Okay, so spill the tea. What did you dug up?
Okay, so get this. The Grammys, they weren't like a preordained thing, right? They weren't like inevitable. They actually kind of came from this whole like rivalry, this sense of competition with, you guessed it, Hollywood.
No way.
Right? Yeah. So like think about it. It's the 1950s, right? Hollywood's like the big dog on the block, right? They got the Oscars. They got the Emmys.
All the glitz and glamour.
Exactly. And apparently there were some, you know, some big wigs, some recording executives back in the day were like, hold on a minute. Music's important too. We deserve our own fancy awards show.
Okay, so they were feeling a little bit left out, huh?
A little bit. It was more like a full-blown case of FOMO. They were like, we're not getting enough stars on the Walk of Fame. Fine, we'll make our own stars. Or, you know, golden gramophones, as it turned out.
I love that. Okay, so they decided, we're doing this. We need to have a music awards show. But then they had to come up with a name. Do they actually consider calling it the Eddies? Because I heard that somewhere and I kind of love it.
I am not making this up. Eddie was on the table.
Get out.
Yeah, they were tossing around Eddie, like, you know, after Thomas Edison, the dude who invented the phonograph.
Oh, I see. Okay, that makes sense now.
Right. It's like music awards, not Edison, not Eddies.
I see what they were going for, but...
But cooler heads prevailed, thankfully. And they went with Grammys.
Grammys, okay, yeah.
Which, of course, is a nod to Emil Berliner's gramophone.
Okay, and remind us, what was the gramophone again?
So the gramophone was one of the first, like, commercially successful devices for playing recorded sound. Like, this was a big deal. Before that, you wanted to hear music. You had to, like, find someone to play it live.
Wow. So that name, Grammy.
Uh-huh.
It's like this really direct link back to the technology of music, the roots of recorded music.
Right. It's not just a catchy name. It's got history.
I'm into it. Okay, so they've got the name, but now what? Like, how do you even begin to put together an award show from scratch?
Well, it was definitely a learning curve. I mean, the first Grammys, get this, they were actually for achievements in 1958, but the actual ceremony, they didn't have it until 1959.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So 1959 was a big year for the Grammys. They had the first ceremony. And it was, get this, bi-coastal.
Bi-coastal? What does that even mean? Like, were there two ceremonies?
Two ceremonies. They held it in New York and California at the same time.
Oh, wow. Fancy. But probably a logistical nightmare.
Oh, I can only imagine. And think about it. This was way before the internet. Before, you know, instant communication across the country.
Right. Yeah, that's true. Okay, so they had these two ceremonies going on simultaneously. How many awards were even given out back then?
Okay, so brace yourself. This is going to blow your mind. 28 awards total.
28.
That's it. Think about how many categories there are now.
Oh, I know. And it's not even like a set number, right? Like, hasn't the number of categories changed over the years?
Totally. It's always evolving. Like, at one point, there were over 100 Grammy categories.
100.
What?
Yeah. Can you imagine trying to keep track of all that?
No.
That's wild. But okay, that kind of makes sense, right? Think about how much music has changed over the years. New genres pop up, technology changes.
Exactly. And the Grammys, they've kind of had to adapt to keep up with all of that. I mean, it's not just about like who's got the best singing voice anymore. It's about production. It's about songwriting. It's about like pushing the boundaries of what music can even be.
Right. So how have they actually done that? Like, how do you even go about changing the categories for something as big as the Grammys?
Well, they've done it a few times throughout the years. They're constantly reevaluating, you know, adding categories, getting rid of others, trying to make sure they're really capturing the full spectrum of what's happening in music.
So, like, what's a specific example of that? Like, when they've actually made a change that really, like, shook things up?
Well, one of the biggest shakeups was in 2012. They did this major overhaul of the whole category system.
2012, okay. Why was that such a big deal? What was going on then?
Well, for one thing, you had the rise of digital music, right? like streaming was becoming huge.
That's true. Yeah. Everything was shifting online.
Right. And so it was like, how do you categorize music when the lines are getting blurrier? Like what's pop, what's R&B, what's, you know, electronic.
It's so true. Everything was getting all mashed up.
Yeah. And so they had to like rethink the whole system.
So it seems like the Grammys, they're not just about the awards themselves, right? Like, they really do reflect all of these bigger changes happening, both in music and in, like, technology and, like, how we even listen to music.
Exactly. It's like they're a snapshot of, like, music history in a way.
That's pretty cool when you think about it like that. It's like they've become this cultural institution.
Totally. And it all started because some music executives were feeling a little, shall we say, overshadowed by Hollywood.
I love it. So next time you're watching the Grammys, remember, it's more than just like fancy outfits and acceptance speeches.
It's about the power of music. It's about the people who make it and the ways it connects us all.
It's like a whole story, a whole journey that's playing out right there on our screens.
Yeah.
And we just scratched the surface here, right?
Oh, yeah, totally. Like, think about all the other award shows out there, right?
The Oscars, the Emmys.
Like, what are their stories? Where'd they come from? What juicy rivalries and behind-the-scenes drama led to those golden statues?
I don't know, but I'm ready to find out. All right, everybody, that's it for today's deep dive.
Keep those turntables spinning.
And we'll catch you next time.
Legacies Podcast.